students, how are you? I hope you're all doing good. So let's begin the new topic that we will be discussing today. So as we know that we have already started the chapter, that is wind, storm and cyclone, and we have already discussed that how wind is formed and what is the main reason behind it, the formation of the wind. Today we will discuss about the thunderstorm, which is a kind of a wind. But this is quite better to say that it is a quite a natural phenomena. This thunderstorm is a natural phenomena. You will see that whenever the rain is happening, it is associated with what? It is associated with the lightning. Lightning, we have seen that most of us have noticed that whenever there is a rain, the rain is associated with this lightning. And these strong with the lightning and thunder is called a thunderstorm. মানে ঝড় বৃষ্টি যেটা আমরা বলি বাংলাতে যেটা বলি ঝড় বৃষ্টি ঝড় উঠেছে বৃষ্টি হচ্ছে মেঘ ডাকছে that these things are called thunderstorm. The thunderstorm developed in hot, humid, tropical areas very frequently. Hot, humid, tropical areas means which are the areas? It's not like India, but what in areas like as this is the earth, and I told you that Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn and Equator, these three all together, this area the covered by the Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn is called a tropical areas, right? And these areas actually face this thunderstorm. You will see that these areas, the countries present over here, the lands present over here, generally face this kind of phenomena, that is thunderstorm. That means ঝড়ের সাথে বাজ পড়া বৃষ্টি হওয়া যেটা এই তিনটে জিনিস যখন একসাথে হয় these phenomena is called a thunderstorm. Okay, let's see. So we have understood what is thunderstorm. So in a better way, that is strong with rain, lightning, thunder, all these together is called thunderstorm. The swift movement of the falling water along with the rising warm air producing sound, lightning, heavy rain and strong winds means jhor, sound means ba jeta awaj beroy mane khub ba, tarpore lightning means baj pora, tarpor hocche heavy rain we know that ekbare khub bhaloi drishti pore jokhon oi shomoy hoy like kal boishakhi. We mean whenever the April months arise, everyone say Kal Boishakhi. So that is actually thunderstorm. Strong winds is called thunderstorm. So as you can see, what is thunderstorm? Thunderstorm is a swift movement of the falling water along with the rising warm air, producing sound, lightning, heavy rain. And strong wind is called thunderstorm. Now we have understood what is thunderstorm. Amra konta ke bolbo? Amra eto kichu dekhi brishti porche, hawa dicche, eto kichu dekhi. Tar moddhe konta ke thunderstorm bolbo? Jekhane jhor, jekhane theke jhorer sathe amar ye bero, mane like particular name. Thunderstorm doesn't have any particular name. Like cyclone has a name, but the storm doesn't have any particular name. It happens at least once in a day, and basically it happens, you better to say that it's in the month of like March to March to June, July, like this. It happens in that time. Because in that time, you can take an idea, in that time, the temperature is very high. The temperature of the earth is very high, right or not? At that point of the time, the temperature of the earth is very high. And at the same time, we know when the temperature of the earth is very high, that means the more and more heating will occur. And as the more and more heating will occur, low pressure region will create. And these low pressure region will create a strong winds. And these strong winds may be the reason of which causing us a thunderstorm. So let's understand. Okay, so we can understand all this is because of the this thunderstorm is all because of the what? Is because of the rising of or formation of a low pressure region. And due to this low pressure region, you will find that these kind of phenomena or these kind of disasters are happening quite frequently in India or in our place. Because our place falls under the tropical region. Our place falls under the tropical region because the Tropic of Cancer is passing over the West Bengal region. Now, let's come to the next. That is that what are the main, what are the main components or what should we require for the formation of thunderstorm? What should we require? We understood that this thunderstorm is formed because of the low pressure region. Because of the low pressure region, because here you see strong wind, and wind is formed because of what? Because of the low pressure. So because of the low pressure, this thunderstorm is formed. But alone low pressure does not help us. There should be another reason by which we are having this lightning, this sound. Okay, so we will understand that what are the mechanism of this thunderstorm, how this thunderstorm is formed. But before that, we need to know that what we need for the formation, what components are required for the formation of thunderstorm. Okay, let's see. For the formation of the thunderstorm, we require moisture, because without moisture, we require moisture. Then the sea breeze or a mountains, we know what is sea breeze, right? Sea breeze means air coming from sea to land, right? We have discussed, go through the last video. In that video, I have discussed what is sea breeze. So, we know what is sea breeze. And we also know that how it is happening. Because of the rising of the rising, and because this is a land and this is a water, since we know the land is getting hotter than the water. So what will happen? The air present above the land will rise up and creating a low pressure region. So what will happen? The air present above the water will move towards this low pressure region, creating a wind. And these winds are called sea breeze. This is what we have discussed in the last class. And this low pressure region, and this we have studied in the last class. Now, for thunderstorm, For thunderstorm formation, we need what? We need moisture, rapidly rising air, and sea breeze. So we can understand, we can get an idea that this sea breeze is coming, since it is a sea breeze, then this air will carry maximum amount of what? Water droplets along with it. Since it is a sea breeze, that means it will carry the maximum amount, the percentage of the water vapor in this air will be maximum. And which will lead to the falling of what? Falling of the rains. Which will lead to the falling of rains and rains. And now we will understand what is the reason behind the formation of this thunder or a lightning or a sound, whatever we say. Okay, let's go through the mechanism behind this formation of this thunderstorm. So now understand the mechanism behind this thunderstorm, that how this thunderstorm is formed. We should know, because generally the wind, how wind is formed, we know, but how this wind convert to thunderstorm, that is the question. So let's understand the mechanism. We know that whenever generally the thunderstorm comes around something around like tropical areas, that means mostly we have seen this around June, July, August, till that time only we see most of these phenomena. I don't know about others, but generally in Arambagh, so I'm talking about Arambagh only. So let's understand the mechanism. Generally we know that warm air, in that time the temperature is high and we know it will create an intense heating, and intense heating will lead to the warm air, and this warm air will happen what? This warm air will rise up, but it will rise up with a lot of moisture. Moisture means it, from where it will get moisture? From plants, because plants also undergo what? Transpiration, and also from the other lake, rivers, whatever they have, it undergoes, the warm air rises with a lots of moisture. The rising temperature will produce an upward rising wind. Of course, as a temperature, we know at that time the temperature is very high. Summer season, March to June, the temperature is very high. And since the temperature is high, it will produce an upward rising wind. Of course, the warm air will rise up and rise up and rise up, and creating the low pressure. Now what will happen? When this warm air will rise up, at higher altitudes, the water droplet freeze. This warm air will freeze. Since this warm air contains moisture, this moisture will condense and freeze to ice. First it will convert to water droplets, and then water droplets to ice. And after that, what will happen? Since it has converted into a ice, it is a heavier. Ice is heavier than water and gas. It will fall towards the earth due to gravity. After that, what will happen? After rising at a higher altitude, it is falling down due to the earth's gravity, what will happen? This frozen ice will melt to a water droplets and falling as a heavy rain, because maximum of the air containing the moisture had already risen up. And it is containing a maximum amount of water, and it is falling as a heavy rain. Now, I have understood that how heavy rain is causing. But how lightning and sound is causing? This lightning and sound is causing due to the friction. Remember, this is very important. It may ask that how the lightning and the sound is caused in the thunderstorm. The friction due to the movement of water droplets. The friction due to the movement of water droplets and the ice crystal along with the rising air creates lightning. Understood? So friction, due to the friction, because we know whenever there is a friction, what will happen? Due to the friction of the two water droplets, this and this air friction, and what will, it is causing a lightning and sound. Now moving to the next that, okay, let's see how it is happening. Okay, let me show you with a diagram that how it is happening. So what is happening? See, suppose this is the land and this is a sun. Intense heating will cause, sun rays are falling over it. Now what will happen? The air over here will rise up. Since the temperature is high, it will rise constantly at a very higher altitude. And what will happen? Now, once it is reaching the higher altitude, this air containing moisture will form a cloud, will condense to form a cloud. And these clouds again will give us what? After formation of the cloud, when the maximum of the clouds are formed due to friction between the clouds also, we can say friction between the clouds and the clouds and water droplets causing, this cloud containing water droplets causing lightning and the sound, and along with it, the heavy rainfall is also occurring. This is what actually happening in this thunderstorm. Now let's list what is the destructive, what happens when thunderstorm happens. We have seen the destruction caused by the thunderstorm. There is no major destruction, but still it is very dangerous. It's very dangerous because you cannot go outside when there is a thunderstorm. When there is a thunderstorm, we cannot go outside. So what are the destruction that is caused by the thunderstorm? That is that sometimes we have seen that electric poles have been ulte gache, the broken electric poles, broken trees, broken trees, even it destroy the electrical appliances, electricity, the bigger towers. If this struck by this lightning, if it is struck by the lightning, then it destroy the electrical appliances. So see, the destruction is, it can destroy the electrical appliances and many more. Trees, appliances, we have seen the poles, electric poles, and sometimes we have seen that it can even the weak house, it can be blown away by the house, by this storm, the house can also be blown away, small huts blown away by the storm. These, and the second is like, for example, the trees. I have to talk about trees. Trees, sometimes this storm can also uproot the trees also. So there are very destruction caused due to it. But these destruction are quite mere. It can be dangerous. Sometimes it cannot be. So what are the effective measures should we take during this type of destruction? That is also a question. What are the safety measures when this thunderstorm occurs? Safety measures that we can take. The safety measures that we can take is that do not take shelter in an isolated tree. Better, because whenever there is a tall trees, these most of these lightning and thunders are actually fall over these trees, because the trees are quite small, are attracted by it. So it is tell that do not take shelter under the tree. Of course, whenever there is a storm or strong lightning and a thunder, it's better that we should not touch any electrical appliances. Do not touch, and also switch off all the electrical appliances. Stay at home. One of the best measure is that during this storm, do not go outside. Stay indoors. Even if it is emergency can happen, but until unless it is a very emergency, then don't go outside. Always stay indoors whenever there is a thunderstorm. And of course, stay away from water bodies, because don't keep yourself in touch with the water. Why? Water bodies mean swimming pool or pond. Suppose you are having a good moment, you went for a swimming pool. At that point, stay away from this kind of water bodies, because the thunderstorms are actually quite, it has high voltage, and if that thunderstorm falls on water, it may be very dangerous for you, for your body, maybe you can die also. So it's better that stay away from the water bodies. Okay, so stay away. Now these are the quiet measures that we have to take during the thunderstorm. So till now we'll discuss this much only. In the next class, we will discuss about the cyclones and also about the tornadoes. Okay, till now, thank you and have a nice day.